Welcome to another Revel University video tutorial. This video will cover everything you need to know about the Schedules tab, including how to set up rules for your business regarding payroll, how to schedule employees, and more. As with all of our tutorials, you can jump ahead to any topic that is most important to you. All of our videos have a table of contents listed below, or you can use the time bar to jump ahead. So let's get started with schedules and payroll in the Management Console. Before you begin creating schedules or tracking payroll in Revel, it's best to review the Timesheet Rules tab first. To access this, click on the Schedules tab, then choose Timesheet Rules. From here, you'll see a number of settings. Each item is described more in detail if you move over the question mark for that setting. Here, I'll highlight some of the more important settings, but be sure to review our Timesheet Rules article linked below. First, we have maximum regular hours per day, which will determine the number of hours that each employee can work per day, including any paid breaks, before qualifying for overtime. Maximum overtime hours per day will be the number of overtime hours that an employee can work per day. After their maximum overtime hours are reached, the system will calculate the employee's wages as double time. The overtime rate multiplier will be the rate that an employee's wage increases for overtime. The same for the double time rate multiplier as well. If you'd like to allow your employees to clock in before their scheduled start time, be sure to enable Allow Clock In Before Shift. Once enabled, you can set a limit for how early you'll allow them to clock in before their scheduled start time. If not enabled, employees won't be able to clock in until the exact time they're scheduled. You can also prevent employees from clocking in early from their breaks by activating Prevent Employee Clock In Before Break. If you are an establishment that allows tipping, we recommend that you enable the Display Declared Tips in Payroll as well as Display Payment Tips in Payroll, so that both cash and credit card tips show in your payroll report. By default, time in Revel will be tracked using military time, but you can switch this to a 12-hour clock if you prefer. If Enable Auto Clock Out is activated, any employees still logged in will be clocked out at the set time. This allows managers to easily identify who forgot to clock out and make those time card corrections accordingly. In Revel, you can export to a few different payroll options, including ADP and paychecks. If either of these are enabled, you'll have additional export options on your payroll report. Just be sure that any employee IDs in Revel match those in the external software as well. Once you've reviewed and updated all necessary settings, be sure to save. Next up are shift schedules, which allow you to create employee schedules for each employee with the start and end time of their shifts. To create a schedule, click Shift Schedules. You'll notice there are some filter and display options. By default, the shift schedule will show all roles, but you can use the drop-down to filter and view only shift schedules for certain roles or departments. Also by default, you'll see the time format set to decimal, but you can change this to hours and minutes format if you prefer. The date range allows you to set shift schedules well in advance or just for the current week. Copy shift allows you to copy the current week's shift to future weeks, which is useful if employees have set schedules each week. And finally, we have the import option. As with other parts of the system, Revel makes it easy for you to import and export your employee shifts. Just click the Import Export button for a template, fill it out accordingly, and then import back into Revel. Other options here include the ability to show all employees, which will display active and inactive employee schedules. Hide Empty will hide any employees that do not have any schedules assigned for the selected date range. And the last two checkboxes will show additional columns on the shift schedule. So if Include Total Wages is activated, then the employee's total wages based on the hours scheduled will display in a new column. And if Display Roles is activated, Then a new column will appear showing the assigned role for which each employee is scheduled. You can use these filters and options at any time, before or after your schedules are created. Now that we've talked through some of these filters, let's create a schedule. First, select a desired time slot for an employee. A new window will display. Verify that the information at the top for the employee and date are correct. Then select Add New. Enter the start time for the employee's shift, followed by the end time. Note that the end time can be either the end of their shift or the time you want them to take a break or lunch. The end status will default to clock out, but you can change this to break if you're scheduling a break time. The last option is roles. If an employee is assigned multiple roles, you can select which role they are working for that shift. If an employee will return from a lunch or break, repeat the previous steps. You can repeat these steps as many times as needed to create an employee schedule for the day. Save when finished and repeat for each additional employee. Now that your employees are scheduled, if they have an email address in the system, you can choose to email them their schedules. Just click the box next to each employee's name and choose Send Email. Or you can print a copy of your schedule by clicking on the PDF or CSV options. Additionally, you can change the view of your schedule. The default is shifts. However, you can choose to view the schedule in hours to see how many hours each employee is scheduled each day, or you can choose to view the schedule using the wage and forecasting option. The last option here gives you the ability to see break information, including when and for how long a break or lunch is scheduled. Next up is the Time Work tab, which displays the exact times that your employees clocked in and out. If someone forgets to clock in or out, you can also edit their time worked on this page. The filters that appear here are similar to the ones we saw in the shift schedule section, including the ability to filter by roles, set your preferred time format, and date range. You can also use the bullet options to show all, hide empty, and activate those additional columns for wages and roles. If you need to edit an employee's time in or out, locate that field on the table. On the information line, you can edit the start and end time, end status, role, and/or wage. There's also a remarks field here, which is required, so you must enter the reason you are updating the employee's time. You can also add a new line if necessary, so if an employee forgot to clock in from lunch and you want to add the time punch before the employee clocks out for the day. Just be sure to save when finished. You can edit time worked as needed for any employee. After time edits are complete, if you have the employee's emails added to Revel, you can email them to the employee for verification. Check the box to the left of the employee's name, then click Send Emails. Once the employee receives the email, they will be able to view the edits and either accept them or reject them. You can also print the time edits for your employees to review by selecting the PDF or CSV options at the top. The last option under Schedules that we'll discuss in this video is the Payroll Report. This allows you to view the total wages that an employee earns, which can be printed out for your payroll department or, if enabled, exported to ADP or Paychecks. Please note, external subscriptions may be required in order for integrations to work successfully. Under Payroll, you'll see all available payroll features in the upper right-hand corner, many of which we've already seen on the other scheduling tabs. These include filtering by roles, selecting your time format, and indicating the date range you want to view. When setting your date, you can either click in the date field and select a predetermined time range from the dropdown, or you can set a specific date range. Custom is a great tool if you do your payroll bi-weekly or for specific dates, such as the 1st and 15th. You also have the Show All, Hide Empty, and the ability to add a column to expand each employee's roles. Once the appropriate date range is selected, you'll see a table that includes a list of every employee and their total hours and wages. Following the role column, you'll see the wage column. If expand roles is enabled, the wage column displays the hourly wage the employee earns for each hour of the week. If expand roles is not enabled, these columns will appear blank. The regular hours worked column shows you how many hours the employee worked at their normal pay rate. Next are the columns to show the number of overtime and double time hours accrued. And the next columns for regular pay, overtime pay, and double time pay are calculated based on the employee's hourly wage multiplied by the overtime and double time rates indicated in the Timesheet Rules tab. The total hours worked column shows just that, the total hours that an employee has worked for the pay period. The total pay column shows the total amount an employee has earned for that period, including regular, overtime, and double time pay. If display declared tips and/or display payment tips are activated under timesheet rules, these columns will appear displaying the tips for each employee for the pay period. To download, print, or email the payroll report, select from any of the export options. If integrations with ADP or Paychex were enabled, those export options will appear here as well. The last option that you may see under the Schedules tab is tip pooling. Since tip pooling is primarily a feature used by table service restaurants, we won't cover that in this tutorial. If this is something you're interested in, please visit the links below for more information. And that about covers the Schedules tab in Revel. We hope you found it helpful and were able to follow along to complete the necessary steps. If you have any additional questions, please visit the related knowledge base articles or video tutorials linked below. Thank you for watching another Revel University video tutorial.